Welcome back to a new video in Link Tutorials. Today I will show you how to use the operator sequence equal in a link query. I already published different videos about other operators. If you want to learn more about link and UiPath, I recommend you to watch these videos in my channel. Let's start. Sequence equal determines whether two sequences are equal by comparing the elements or not. It means we have two sequences and we want to check if both are the same. Two sequences are the same if both have the same number of elements, and also the same elements in the same order. The result of this operator is of type Boolean. It means, if both sequences are the same, we get true, else we get false. There are two overloads for this operator. The first one is as following. We have both sequences, and the operator is between them. The second overload is also the same, but here we have a comparer on the right side. What does each overload mean and how to use? I will show you that later. But before that, you have to know that you can use the operator always for the same data types. It means, you can only compare two sequences of the same data type. For example, an integer array with an integer array. Or string array with a string array, and so on. So you cannot compare an array with data table, for example. We can also use this operator to compare two strings. So the sequence must not be a complex data type, like array or list. And you have to know that you cannot compare each kind of sequences, like compare two data tables. Later in the examples, you can understand what I mean with this point. The last thing you have to know about this operator, that you can use it only as method. That's all about this operator. Let's now switch to UiPath to see some examples. How can we use this operator within a link query? In the first example, I will show you how to use this operator in both overloads. I will start with the first overload. I have these two variables. Both are of type string array. Each array contains the same elements. I have these four names, which are written the same and are in the same order. I want to compare these two variables using sequence equal operator. Here I have another variable of type Boolean to store the output of comparing both variables. I use the variable in this assign activity. Let's see what I have here. I only use the variables with the operator. So I want to compare the first array with the second array. I don't have a comparer here. Here I added write line activity to print out the result. Let's execute the code to check the result. As you see, I got true because both sequences are the same. Let's now change the order of the elements in one array. So I have the same elements in both variables, but the order is not the same. I will execute the code again. As you see, I got false because both sequences are not the same. I will change the content again. I will set the same order for both variables, but now I will use capital letter. So I have the same count of elements and the same order, but the elements are not the same. Let's execute the code to check the new result. As you see, I got false again, because the sequences are not the same. So we have the same number of elements and also the same order and same elements, but the strings are written in different case. We can avoid that using a comparer. As you know, the second overload for sequence equal contains a comparer. So let's see how can we use the second overload with a comparer. We have string arrays, therefore we need a string comparer. I will add the comparer at this point. So I want to ignore case, therefore I use this option. This means now, I want to compare both arrays, to check if I have the same number of elements, the same elements and also the same order. But if the letters are written in upper or lower case, it's not relevant. I used here a string comparer, because I want to compare strings. But if I have another data type, I have to use another comparer. In UiPath, we don't have a comparer for each data type, therefore we have to implement it in this case. For example, if we want to compare two data tables, we have to implement a comparer for that. In this case, we can use the implemented comparer to compare both tables. Let's now execute the code again and check if we will get true or false. As you see, I got true as output. So both sequences are the same. This is how to use sequence equal operator in both overloads. These examples were only an introduction for you, how to use the operator in both ways. Now I will show you an example in UiPath, where I use the operator in a link query for a data table. In this example I will show you, how can we get the unique rows from a data table using sequence equal operator. I have the following sequence. First I have a build data table activity, where I define a table. It will be stored in this variable. Let's see the table. It consists of two columns, ID and name. I have different rows in this table. Some rows appears more than once. As mentioned, I want to get the unique rows from this table. It means, I want to get only these two rows, which appears only once in the table. Here I have an assign activity, where I wrote the link query. First I have a loop for the rows of the table. After that I used let operator with a variable x. This variable is to store the count of one row, to check if it appears only once or more than once. I used here the variable row with the function item array. If you don't know, what does it exactly mean, I will show you that. If we use a data row variable with the function item array, we get the content of each column for this row. For example, I have the following table with one row. If I am using item array for one row, I will get the following output. It's an array of type object, which contains the content of each column. As you see, I have strings, numbers and boolean. So this array is always of type object. Let's go back to the query. So I use the operator sequence equal to compare the current row with the rows of the table, if we have the same row in the table. For that I use the data table variable with where operator. Here I set a condition to check, if the item array of the current row is exact the same as any other row in the same table. It means, I am comparing the current row with each row of the table. I used here the first overload of operator sequence equal. The result for this expression is a collection of rows. So I have here the table, and also the item array for each row. In the first loop I am in the first row. For this row I will check the entire table, if I have the same row. As you see, I have the same row only once at the beginning. It means, this expression returns a collection of one row. After that I used count function, to get the count of this collection. It means, if the row appears only once, I will get a collection consisting of only one row. In this case the count is one. If the row appears twice, I will get a collection consisting of two rows. In this case the count is two, and so on I can check each row. Let's check it for the second row. As you see, I have this row twice. So this expression returns a collection of two rows. And the count is two. It means now, that x variable is of type integer and contains the occurrence count of the current row. After that I have the condition using x variable. Here I am checking if x is equal to 1. This means that I am checking, if the row appears only once. If it's correct, I will select this row. After the query I am converting the output to data table using copy to data table function. This is how the query works. Here I have a loop for the table, to print out the content of the table. I used here also item array, to print out the content of one row from each column. Let's execute the code to check the result. As you see, I got only two rows. These rows appears only once in the table. Let's now see, how to get only the duplicate rows from the table. It means, I want now to get only the rows, which appears more than once in the table. For that I only have to change the condition to get the rows, where the count is greater than one. As before mentioned, this variable contains the occurrence count of each row. Once I set it greater than one means, that I want to get each row, which appears more than once. Let's execute the code again to check the new result. As you see, I got all rows from the table, which appears more than once. This is how to use the operator to compare the rows of a data table. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed the video and learned something new and interesting. If you still have any questions, please don't hesitate to write us back. Thanks for watching and have a great day.